And guys, we have some huge information coming out, some very important stuff here, and it says the Bear MiG-31 jet chases British spy plane out after its V airspace. This is huge, guys, and we have some more information. I want to show you something really quick here, guys. I can't show you the article, but I can read it. Now, this is for subscribers only, those that pay monthly. But, guys, I'm hearing that there's a possibility in the next 3 weeks, there's going to be something big to come between NATO members and the Bear. Now, let me read this really quick. And it says here, you have some intelligent resources tell me, again, they are telling Hal Turner, tell me that the largest bare air military operations in the last 30 years is being prepared in the next few weeks. Possibility in the next 3 weeks, there's going to be something big to come between NATO members and the bear. Now, let me read this really quick. And it says here, you have some intelligent resources. Tell me, again, they are telling Hal Turner, tell me that the largest bear air military operations in the last 30 years is being prepared in the next few weeks. The air operation will be allegedly carried out by massive aviation strikes. And go figure, you have this thing going on here, guys.
In a strange scene, a mysterious cube of light and a swarm of mysterious light balls, and what looks like a gate, were seen in the sky during stormy weather and summer clouds in the sky of Phoenix, Arizona. In a related context, the sightings of unidentified flying objects, mysterious phenomena, and unexpected weather changes continued in many countries of the world. Where a strange cube of light was seen hanging from the clouds in the sky of Phoenix, followed by the appearance of a swarm of mysterious light balls circling in the sky. It was 7 in the evening and there was a summer rainstorm clouds forming in the sky. In Sheba.
Some of our viewers may say, we cannot trust Iran. Mm-hmm. What are your thoughts?
I mean, I don't think we can trust this country. I mean, what has this country done to the majority of the countries in the Middle East? You know, like, I don't think Iran's having nuclear weapons. I'm a pacifist. I don't believe in violence. But also, when we look at the legacy of imperialism and colonization in the Middle East, and we see the legacy of this country and all of the violence that it has not only created, but also created the capacity for. A lot of these weapons in the Middle East are completely brought in by the United States.
A lot of Americans might take offense to that. You're an American. You don't sound like an American, would you say? You know what I mean?
That's because I've read, you know? Yeah. And I think that it's really important that we look beyond sort of these really simple narratives that we're told, whether it's about Muslim women, whether it's about the legacy of this country, and knowing that this country literally was built on the backs of black slaves and after the genocide of indigenous what they're wearing.
Let's talk about nuclear weapons.
Okay.
Some of our viewers may say, we cannot trust Iran.
Mm-hmm.
What are your thoughts?
I mean, I don't think we can trust this country. I mean, what has this country done to the majority of the countries in the Middle East? You know, like, I don't think Iran's having nuclear weapons. I'm a pacifist. I don't believe in violence. But also...
What are you going to educate them in? Military skills? We're not so good at that anymore. The Queen doesn't have enough soldiers. We ran away from Basra under fire, whipped. The United States withdrew from Iraq, beaten by the resistance of the Iraqi people. We're running out of Afghanistan, and we'll be very lucky if it's only the Taliban that come back to power. Because competing against the Taliban is ISIS. The Taliban are the moderates in the fight that's about to ensue. So the West is a military failure, with all respect to the honorable and gallant officers here present this evening. Really? What are you going to educate them in? Military skills? We're not so good at that anymore. The Queen doesn't have enough soldiers. We ran away from Basra under fire, whipped. The United States withdrew from Iraq, beaten by the resistance of the Iraqi people. We're running out of Afghanistan, and we'll be very lucky if it's only the Taliban that come back to power. Because competing against the Taliban is ISIS. The Taliban are the moderates in the fight that's about to ensue. So the West is a military failure, with all respect to the honorable and gallant officers here present this evening.
Supreme Court made this extreme decision to take away a constitutional right. It was an unconstitutional action by them, a right that was around for almost 50 years, a right that women had to make a decision on their bodies and how they want to start their families.
The Constitution? Well, I got one right here. Let's read it, Karen. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. And further down it says that we, the people, and all people, have the rights that among these are life, liberty, and pursuit of happiness. Constitution doesn't give anyone the right to abortion, murder. It gives the right to life to every born and unborn human. How did you even get your job?
Get 50.
What are you going to educate them in? Military skills? We're not so good at that anymore. The Queen doesn't have enough soldiers. We ran away from Basra under fire, whipped. The United States withdrew from Iraq, beaten by the resistance of the Iraqi people. We're running out of Afghanistan, and we'll be very lucky if it's only the Taliban that come back to power. Because competing against the Taliban is ISIS. The Taliban are the moderates in the fight that's about to ensue. So the West is a military failure, with all respect to the honorable and gallant officers here present.